If you haven't looked at any of Apple's accessibility features because you're not blind or deaf, so you don't think there's anything in there for you, you might be surprised. There's something in there for everybody. That's kind of the whole point. There are five awesome accessibility features coming to iOS 17 this year that I'm going to show you. Number one is one called Assistive Access. This pares down your phone to its most basic features to lessen the cognitive load of using it. If someone you know might be overwhelmed by the complexity and density of using a smartphone, turning on Assistive Access will make it easier for you to stay in touch with them with a modern smartphone, but it'll be simpler and easier for them to use. The setup process is a little complicated. You need to have a recovery Apple ID and a few other steps as I'm walking through right here. But once you have it set up, your phone will spin for a little bit and it'll reboot into this special mode where you have giant, easy to read icons for all of the most essential features. As you can see, the camera app is really simple with just one big button to take a picture. The photos app just scrolls through the recent pictures. The messages app is really simple with just these big lists of people to talk to and messages to send. And any app from the App Store can still be enabled to run as is if you need a special app for a health monitoring system or your RSS feeds. Number two is a system called Live Speech. You can activate this in Settings, Accessibility. You have to scroll all the way down and tap Live Speech. And then you either triple-click the home button or you add a button to Control Center to turn on live speech. Now this lets you type with the keyboard to speak. If you're in person, it'll just play over the phone speakers, or you can do this on a phone call or a FaceTime call. And here you can set a few favorite phrases in advance. You type them in, and then you have a little shortcut when you activate live speech. This leads me to number three, a system called Personal Voice. This lets you use live speech with your own voice. You need to train it in advance. For about an hour, you talk into your phone with your own voice, reading a bunch of phrases that appear on screen. After that, you plug your phone in, let it churn. It'll create a digital model of your voice that you can use with live speech to sound like it's really your voice talking out of your phone. As you can hear, it is definitely my voice powering the feature, but I don't think anyone would be fooled into thinking it's my natural voice. It doesn't speak with a lot of emotion. Apple does a good job of inflecting Siri phrases with emotion. Some of that effort could be reused here. Anyways, now I'm about to introduce number four, detection mode. Number four, detection mode. If you're low vision, you can download the magnifier app from the App Store and tap this button right here that kind of looks like a full screen icon. That'll turn on detection mode. From there, you can tap these little detectors along the side to turn on various features. Door detection will tell you how close you are to a door, if it has any writing on it, whether it's open or closed. People detection will tell you how close you are to another person in the room. And image descriptions will tell you what objects or things your phone is pointing at. This leads into number five, point and speak. You hold your hand in front of your camera and you can point at labels on appliances like microwaves or ovens, and it'll read out what the label says. If you have trouble reading your oven, for example, you can point and see what temperature you have it set to. You can see what features on the microwave you have. It's not perfect, but it works pretty well and it could be a literal lifesaver. So those are some of the accessibility features coming in iOS 17. Check out an article with even more. Check out my other videos where I talk about more hidden features coming this fall. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.